local news that matters on Local 22 News.
At this place in history, we're in Burlington with Executive Director of the Vermont Historical Society, Steve Perkins. Now, Steve, this is a spot that this place in history has visited before.
Yep. 4 years ago, if you can imagine that, we were right here.
So what brings us back then?
So at that point, we were talking about the old Burlington Athletic Field, mm-hmm. right over our shoulders here. It's now the Charlevoix Trucking Center. You can see it still looks like a baseball
yeah.
field, but we talked a lot about the field itself. But today, I really want to talk about one of the players who played on that field and really made an impact, not just on Vermont, but kind of on the world of sports and then later law.
Wow, who is this?
So William Clarence Matthews. Mm-hmm. So William Clarence Matthews was a black man. He was born in Selma, Alabama, and went to the famous Tuskegee Institute. He studied under Booker T. Washington.
Wow.
Washington said, gosh, this guy is like super intelligent. He's a great athlete. We need to get him into some bigger schools and let's send him north. And so he was able to get him enrolled at Phillips Academy and then later at Harvard University, where he did 4 years and he played a full 4 years on the baseball team at Harvard University. That's where the story gets us to Burlington. And so we need to go back in time and think about professional baseball. Professional baseball had, if you can imagine, a lot more teams than they do today. And there were lots of different leagues. Today we think of the American League and the National League. Those are kind of the two biggest ones. But you also had leagues all over the United States. We have the Northern League. And there were a whole bunch of teams that played across Northern New England, and Burlington had a team, inventively named the Burlington Baseball Team, which had their home field right here. So Matthews was hired to play second base for the Burlington Baseball Team of the Northern League. This is in 1905. This was the first time there was a black baseball player playing professional baseball. And there wouldn't be another one until Jackie Robinson. He only played one season. He played that summer. Certainly he saw a lot of racism. There were a number of players from the South who refused to play against him or were likely to spike him in a couple of games. His manager ended up moving him to the outfield because he was in so much danger of being injured by other players playing second base. But he did, he played all year and he was very effective. And there was even, we'll call it a rumor, maybe some newspaper articles that the Boston Bean Eaters, which was Boston's National League team at the time, was looking to bring him in to play second base. But he ended up leaving baseball after that 1 year. Why? Because he went to law school. He ended up becoming a federal attorney in Boston, trying a number of cases. He then worked on the Calvin Coolidge presidential campaign, became good friends with the president and his administration, and he was appointed an assistant attorney general for the United States, mostly serving in the upper Midwest. He died tragically as a young man of a ruptured ulcer. Those things kind of happened. But I mean, what an incredible career for him to go from Alabama to Tuskegee to Phillips to playing baseball to Harvard to law school to an assistant attorney general in the federal government.
At this place in history.